Hi, my name is Weike Wang, and my book is called Chemistry. I have my undergrad degree in chemistry. I minored in English. Mm-hmm. And after getting an undergrad degree, I went and got a grad degree in biostatistics, epidemiology.
Wow. As so, one does?
Yes. natural transition.
What's harder, science or writing?
I think writing. You obviously have feedback from your friends right. and from your editor, but the ideas actually do have to come from you entirely.
Right.
And in science, it's a little bit more collaborative. You have an advisor, you might have another grad student working on the project, a postdoc, so it becomes a very collaborative group project.
She does not have a name.
She doesn't.
Talk to me about that decision. Why did you decide not to name her?
Well, it's in the first person.
Right.
So when you write something in the first person, you're not always thinking about the name.
You don't need a name
right,
for a while.
Right, you don't need a name for a while. And then I hadn't named any of the characters, and I knew her so well, but I didn't think that the name was necessary. I wanted her to be a little bit more universal to the reader.
Her instinct when faced with something she's not sure she can handle is either denial or destruction. Do you think that is a natural overachiever's tendency?
I do think so. Once you realize you're not as great as you think you are, you want to shut that part down. I think there's also a tendency when things are going wrong, overachievers tend to really like to rebuild very quickly. Mm-hmm. They don't like the sense that things are going wrong, things are going to get worse, things are at rock bottom, right? That process is really uncomfortable for the overachiever. She, being this type A personality, wants to just blank slate very quickly.
Start it over.
And she might have to start over 20 times, but she wants to do it.
If you were an element on the periodic table of elements, which one would you be and why?
I like fluorine.
Fluorine?
Fluorine.
Okay.
The reason I like it is because fluorine hates being alone. It's you never find, you know, F minus in solution.
Okay.
So it really likes to be paired with something like hydrogen. Or itself, right?
Right.
So I kind of like that idea that, you know, whereas, you know, chlorine likes to be by itself.
Okay.
Fluorine doesn't.
Thanks for being with us today.
Thanks for having me.
And thanks for joining us for A Word on Words. I'm Mary Laura Philpott. Keep reading.
Once you finish grad school, every scientist will tell you that they realize they actually don't know anything. You see the limit of human knowledge pretty quickly in any field, I think, particularly in science, what we don't know.